Hi guys, now today we are going to discuss about what Nana, the effects of ecosystem means how the human activities are damaging the ecosystem. Already we have discussed in our earlier classes like 8th and 9th classes, because of human interventions, how the air and water and soil pollution taken place, we have already seen. Okay, in this lesson we'll discuss because of human interventions, how the ecosystem was misbalanced or imbalanced. Okay, and if we cut the forests or if we occupy the water bodies, what are the consequences, we'll discuss with an example of story of Kolleru. Okay, now so fresh water bodies are supplying a lot of nutritional sources to the most poorest people in the worldwide. Okay, so fresh water sources or lakes are the nutritional sources for lot of poorest people in the worldwide, Nana. Like Kolleru is also one of the largest freshwater lake in India. It is one of the largest freshwater lake in India, and it is located between what, Nana? West Godavari and Krishna district. Okay, it is located between West Godavari to Krishna districts, Nana, and it is extended up to 6,121 kilometers of area, square kilometers of area. Yes, and it is filled with a lot of fresh water and lot of wetland areas. And in this area, almost 193 species of varieties of birds are located, along with a lot of flora and fauna, and including lot of medicinal plants. 193 species of birds. Species of birds and medicinal plants and lot of flora and fauna is also present, and lot of nutritional rich information, lot of wetlands are present, and lot of fishes like food material is also available, and almost 20 million people directly or indirectly depended on Kolleru lake. Okay, and moreover, what, Nana? It is sending extra water, flood water of Kolleru is reaching to the Bay of Bengal with the help of Upputeru channel, which runs almost 65 kilometers to send excessive water from the Kolleru lake. And it is also getting a nutritional rich water from the river floods like Krishna river, Godavari river, etc. So it is getting lot of nutritional rich water sources from the rivers which are available in its surroundings of Kolleru. Okay, and because of this diversity of 193 varieties of species of birds and medicinal plants and other flora and fauna, every year it is attracting millions of birds from the other places too. For example, from the North Asia and Eastern Europe countries, every year between March to October, it is attracting what, Nana? 20 lakhs of birds. 20 lakhs of birds every year they are coming to the Kolleru lake. Between March to October or September, 20 lakhs of birds are coming to the Kolleru lake. Okay, so why? Because there is a beautiful atmosphere there. And by all seeing this, in the year 1999, Andhra Pradesh government declared this Kolleru lake is an award and a sanctuary, bird sanctuary. Okay, it is officially decided as what, a bird sanctuary. Why? Because it is giving a place for what, a 20 lakhs of birds from North Asia and also Eastern Europe countries. Like for example, Siberian crane, pelican birds, etc. are also coming to this Kolleru lake, etc. Okay, and it is getting water from the rivers, and excessive water is reaching to the Bay of Bengal from the Upputeru channel, the floods, because of floods. Okay, now nowadays what is happening to this Kolleru, Nana? The size of the Kolleru is shrinking. Yes, and because of occupying the lands, and because of mud, and because of pollution, etc., and because of converting into agriculture lands, etc., the size of the Kolleru Lake is decreasing, and even it is getting a lot of floods. It is getting lot of floods, and it is decreasing the water holding capacity. This was shown by one of the satellites. So in a 2000 area, we got one of the satellite picture of the Kolleru. So that revealed that the Kolleru size is shrinking because of human interventions. Okay. So what are the human interventions taking place there? So in the 1980s, around the 1980s, Nana, almost throughout worldwide aquaculture was started. Nana means what? Nana, rearing of fishes and prawns, etc. started aquaculture. So it became what? Nana, profitable task in 1980s. Okay, aquaculture, rearing of what? Nana, fishes and prawns. So because of this aquaculture profits, investors started to invest the money even in the Kolleru region also. So people started to construct the burns, and they used to trap the water of Kolleru, and they started aquaculture ponds. They created or constructed so many aquaculture ponds in the Kolleru area by taking lot of water into their ponds, etc. Okay, now so much of investors came here to establish or to construct that, and even lot of agriculture land is also by constructing lot of burns, the water stopped. The because of these burns, water from the Kolleru Lake stopped, and they converted them into agriculture lands, started doing agriculture. Because of these aquaculture and agriculture, lot of flow of natural flow of water is diverted. Natural flow of water of this Kolleru Lake is diverted. Then what happened? The size of the Kolleru is gradually shrinking, and it is facing so many floods and so many problems. Okay, clear. And one more important thing, Nana, lot of industries also established in its surroundings, and the development of cities. Okay, so there are so many actions, interventions of human beings lead to the damage or pollution of Kolleru Lake. What happened, Nana? For example, because of agriculture. So because of agriculture, the agriculture runoffs. So we started to use what, Nana? So many pesticides, insecticides and herbicides, etc. to protect our crops. So these all agricultural runoffs are reaching into the aquatic bodies like a Kolleru Lake. Yes, and these aquaculture ponds, they are releasing the waste of these fish ponds, discharging the fish pond wastages directly into the Kolleru Lake. And industries, they are releasing their hazardous chemicals directly into the Kolleru Lake. Okay, and even the developed urban cities, they are releasing their municipal waste and drainages directly into the Kolleru Lake. So because of all these reasons together, what happened, Nana? The Kolleru water is polluted now. The people who are depending on that Kolleru is facing so many problems. So water completely contaminated, that is not useful for what, Nana? Drinking. And also what happened, Nana? Gradually that contaminated water or polluted water becomes what, Nana? Toxicated for lot of fishes and prawns. So the production from aquaculture is also decreased. Production of aquaculture also decreased. Gradually, the diseases also developed in the agriculture also. Okay. Maximum by the year of 1996, total water of Kolleru is under come under the cultivation of aquaculture and agriculture. Okay. So because of these contamination and pollution, aquatic ecosystem damaged and aquaculture damaged by getting lot of diseases to the fishes and prawns, etc. And agriculture lands also become barren because of excessive alkaline. So because of adding of these chemicals, that water turned into alkaline. So this water is not useful for agriculture practices. So lands also become barren. And even because of these chemicals and mud, etc., water become turbid. So dissolving oxygen capacity decreases and BOD increases, biological oxygen demand increases. Okay, and because of these biological oxygen demand and lot of chemicals reached into the water bodies, eutrophication takes place. Now lot of agriculture runoff carry the nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, etc. into the water bodies. This leads to eutrophication, growth of algal colonies and other plants. Means if the algal colony grows more and more, that other aquatic ecosystems are unable to take up the oxygen, dissolved oxygen, etc. Okay, so these contamination of water shows a lot of influences, biological and chemical and physical influences shown on the Kollur Lake. For example, because of aquaculture, what happened, the migratory birds are not coming. Because that fish ponds are what happened in aquaculture. In the aquaculture, they are cultivating only the fishes which are useful for them, monoculture. Because in the place of polyculture, they developed monoculture, which are useful for the investors. So migratory birds are decreased. And the people are facing so many floods because of shrinking of Kollur Lake and water holding capacity decreased. Okay. And because of contamination, people faced water so many problems. Because of water contamination, lot of diseases like cholera, diarrhea, etc. People faced so many problems like cholera, diarrhea, etc. spread. And even because of this contaminated water, communicable diseases because of some insects like mosquitoes, house flies also spreaded. Okay, vector borne diseases also spreaded. Why? Because they don't know, they don't have awareness how this water is contaminating, etc. Okay, so here one table is given, and the case study of Kollur Lake in 1967 and 2004. So area, Varnana lake water spreading area almost 70.70 square kilometers. It is reduced to 62.65 square kilometers by 2004. So this is only of 2004, Nana, not 2014 or 24. Okay, lake with a sparse weed means normal weeds. How, why the weeds will grow, Nana? Because of agriculture runoff, lot of nutrients like NPK is reaching to the water body. Okay, then 47.47 kilometers of area with a sparse weed. Now very dense weed, it is 15.20. The water level to flood in the rainy season. So lot of water, the water holding capacity is more in the 1967. And the flooded water can reach to Bay of Bengal through Puttur. But now, so we are not facing that flooding of water. Okay. Now aquaculture ponds, zero ponds now. 2004, 99.74 kilometers, square kilometers. Rice field just 8.40 square kilometers. But now it is in 2004, 16.62. Now settlements, human settlements surrounding by the Kollur Lake is just 0.31 in 1967, but now it is 1.37. So because of human interventions, lake is facing so many physical and biological and chemical influences, Nana. But eutrophication and siltation, floods, okay. And one more important thing, Nana, that migratory birds are not coming. And gradually, before it was what, Nana, one of the tourist place also. So many visitors will also enjoy the beauty of the nature. But nowadays what is happening, Nana? It is completely contaminated. Okay? So this is the case study of Kollur. So recently, Ministry of Environment and Forest, Ministry of Environment and Forest and also Government of India started one project, what, Nana? Operation Kollur. Started recently one project of Operation Kollur to protect the Kollur from human interventions and human activities, Nana. Okay, the physical and biological chemical influences of Kollur is given in a textbook by showing plus symbol and minus symbols. Na na. Plus symbol means there is an influence of agriculture or aquaculture and human interventions on coral. If there is a minus symbol, so there is no influence of that particular factor on the Kolleru lake. Okay, so this is only one aquatic ecosystem. For example, we occupied the forest land and converted them into agriculture land. Then what happens? So if we occupy one forest land and converted them into agriculture land, what happens? So you know that in a forest there is a different kinds of plants are available. So there is a lot of diversity is available. So that is called polyculture. But wherever we convert the forest, we convert the forest into agriculture field. Agriculture field. What happens, Nana? We grow only certain varieties of plants for rice, our pulses, our fruits, vegetables, etc. Even though the food is available for animals in the form of their roots, leaves, etc. But this is leads to what, Nana? Monoculture. Monoculture. Instead of demands, what we are doing, Nana? We are producing only monoculture. Instead of supply and demand and supply principle, we are producing only the one or two varieties of plants in that area. So monoculture, what, Nana? We are, of course, we are producing huge amount of food materials which is required for the growing population. But at the same time, what is happening, Nana? We are producing more amount of food for the growing population. At the same time, because of monoculture, what is happening, Nana? A lot of pests and lot of fungi and other bacteria, virus, etc., which are causing diseases to the plants also growing. Why? Because they are getting lot of food. So lot of food is available because of monoculture. They are multiplying very quickly. So because of monoculture, they are multiplying very quickly and they are getting lot of food. So they are damaging to the plants in that area. So to control these all pests and fungi and bacteria, again we started to use lot of pesticides and lot of fungicides and other harmful chemicals. Okay, so whenever we started to use these pesticides, somewhat they were controlled that time. Somewhat these pests and fungi and bacteria and virus are controlled and we protected our crop. So for example, the pesticides or fungicides or herbicides, whatever the chemicals, they need, what is their major use, Nana? They need to kill or they need to control especially that harmful insects or harmful fungi or bacteria, etc. So they need not to do any harm other living things which are living on the field. But there is no such kind of perfect pesticide on this earth. So these pesticides, what they are doing, Nana? Even though they are killing harmful pests and fungi and bacteria, etc., they are also killing some useful pests and insects and also some useful bacteria, etc. Okay? For example, these pesticides are also killing some butterflies, honeybees and some wasps, etc. So we have already studied in previous classes what none of these insects are also helping what? For cross-pollination. So there is no perfect pesticide on this earth which is aimed at. So generally they are aimed at what, Nana? To control the pests and fungi, bacteria, etc. So but what? They are also killing some useful living things along with them. Maybe that living things are the predators which killing some your harmful aphids, etc. Or that insects may be the food for or prey for other insects or other birds, etc. So these pesticides not only killing the useful organisms, also they are damaging the ecosystem. So they are also damaging the food chain or they are making the ecosystem imbalance. They are killing useful organisms. Along with that, they are killing predators and prey. So predators are maybe they are eating some harmful insects and their larvae, etc. The insects may be food for the other birds, etc. So in this way, these harmful chemicals, using of chemicals like herbicides, pesticides, etc. also damaging the balance of ecosystem by damaging or breaking their food chains. So this is one problem. And on the other hand, second problem, because of pesticides. Pesticides, some of the pesticides are easily break down in the soil. Whenever they reach to the soil, they break down inside the soil within a very quicker time, that is less than 1 year. In a very quicker time, like less than 1 year, so they may break down in the soil and they mix with the soil. But there are some chemicals like lead or arsenic or mercury, etc. If we use these kind of pesticides, etc., so they may not break down easily and they will not mix with the soil. They are non-biodegradable. Okay, so they are still remains in the soil, and from the soil they are entering into the plant bodies, and from the plant bodies they are entering into the all animals through a food chain. So these harmful chemicals are entering into each and every tropical level in a pyramid, or each and every tropical level in a food chain. The entry of these chemicals into each tropical level is called what, Nana? Bioaccumulation. Bioaccumulation means the entry of the pollutants into each and every tropical level is called bioaccumulation. And these chemicals finally reaching to the lost or top end carnivores, and in a sufficient amount doing and harm to them. For example, DDT. In your 9th class, you have studied in your 8th class. DDT is accumulating in the body of plants and birds. Finally, it is reaching to eagles like structures, top end carnivores. So whenever the saturated level of DDT is reaching to the body of eagles, so these eagles are damaging the eggshells before hatching. So whenever these chemicals or pollutants are accumulating in the body of top end consumers, so they are accumulating enough amount to do harm to that animals. So that is called accumulation. Now, if these pollutants are concentrating in each and every tropic level, means their concentration is increasing in each and every tropic levels, that is called what, Nana? Biomagnification. In each and every tropic level, the concentration of these pollutants are increasing gradually. And whenever they increase, whenever they magnify, what happens, Nana? They show a lot of harmful effects on the top end carnivores. Okay. Now, we'll discuss about how the bioaccumulation and biomagnification showing the effect on different living organisms by taking one case study of Adilabad water reservoir in the next class. Okay. If you have any doubts, please text in the comment box. Until then, thank you.